The next problem statement is to find GCD of three numbers, GCD of three numbers using recursion. So as we are saying three numbers here, we can use the same logic, but there is a sum change which I am making to this two numbers recursion program. Please observe closely. Here I am taking three numbers N1, N2, N3 and result. Here I need to read three variables, so three percentile D's, and here address of N3, address of N3. So here in the function call, so first time I am finding the GCD of two numbers, and then I am going to apply that result to the another variable, the same variable result, GCD of, now whatever the result which you get, whatever the result value whichever you are going to get it, so that you are going to apply for the num3, that is n3 comma res, n3 comma res. Now we are going to find out the resultant value with the third number. So this is how we can find the GCD of three numbers, that is GCD of percentile D comma percentile D, and percentile D is percentile D. Here what should I write? N1, N2 and N3 equal to result. So rest of all the function call is same. So according to the advantage of functions, a function can be written once and it can be called n number of times. So here I am calling the function two times. So the first function call will be for finding the GCD of two numbers. Whatever the result we got, we are storing it in a result variable. Next, the N3 number, the number 3 comma result, we are going to pass again to the GCD so that we can get the GCD of three numbers, right? Now let me execute the code and check whether I am going to get the proper GCD of three numbers or not. So enter the values of N1, N2 and N3. N1, N2 and N3. So total three numbers we are going to enter. Now let me execute this code and check whether I am going to get the proper GCD of three numbers correct or not. So here enter the values of N1, N2 and N3. So I am giving the N1 value as 10 and N2 value as 20 and N3 value as 30. Now the GCD of 10, 20, 30 is 10. So if you can see the factors of 10, they are 1, 2, 5, 10. And the factors of 20 are 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. Factors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, 30. So out of this, which are common? The common are 1, 2, 5, 10. Out of this, which is the greatest one is 10. So this is how we got the greatest common factor of three given numbers in this program. So first we are finding the GCD of N1, N2, that is GCD of 10 and 20 will be 10. That value 10 will be given in the result. Now N3 value is 30, 30 comma 10, and we need to find the GCD of 30 and 10. And your control again goes to the function call, executes these steps, and here you will be getting the greatest common divisor as 10. Now let us check for 30 and 10. And the N3 value is 30. GCD of 30 comma 10. 30 comma 10 is the first N2 value. 10 is not equal to 0. Condition is true. Which means GCD of, what is N2? N2 value is 10 comma, what is N1 mod N2? 30 mod 10. 30 mod 10 is 0. 30 mod 10 is 0. Now GCD of 10 comma 0, which means N1 is 10, N2 is 0. Now check the condition. What is the N2 value? 0. 0 not equal to 0? Condition is false. Then we need to return N1. So what is the N1 value? 10. This 10 is written back to the function. So the value of 10 That is, the GCD of 10, 20 and 30 is 10. This is how the result has been executed.